Tonight I'm going to talk about, it's about compartmentalizing, all types of things. Mainly what's really your controller at the moment. Like, let's say you go to the bank and you look at your account, and then you're like, just before you go to sleep, and you're like, oh my gosh, you know, that's like a sign to me, that number, you know, it's just on your forehead, you know, that number, and it just becomes like an overwhelming, you know, part of your person, and you're like, well, how does this possibly, you know, become me, you know, that number, how could that be my major clothing, you know, my association of self, you know, right there on my forehead, whatever, you know, how many zeros you have, or how little zeros you have, you know, so there is that stress association, that valuation that you put on yourself, you valued yourself, you've actually put a valuation on yourself, and in doing that, you've given yourself an associated stress, an associated, infringement. It's an infringement on your true spirit, your true self. Your true self is not supposed to be associated with a number attachment. Your true self is not supposed to have that. Okay, so now on to this, we're talking about these valuations of the self. You know, we have the money valuation. And it's heavy too, and a lot of us are in these online banks a lot, and we go there, and they really start to assign us, you know. And so there's that valuation, so that's a pretty heavy, thick one, okay. Then we have other things. We have our ideals, you know, your own ideals, and your stringentness with them, your strictness, your fortitude, your stick up to the others about your strength where you hold. I'm sorry, I was making some a frame tonight, and I think I ate sawdust. But anyhoot, we're at the valuations, and included in these valuations of yourself are the ideals, you know. And if you look at it, you know, really simply, look at it like a big wheel. That's you can put it around you, this big wheel, or you can put it in front of you. But a massive wheel. Try not to make it a clock, because that's just so bad. But a big wheel, and think about, well, there's my money valuation. Is it? I'll put it over there, and I'll miss on that part. That'll be my ideals. You know, what I really stand for. You know, like, oh, I'm vegan. You know, diehard vegan. You know, that type of thing. And unfortunately, when those things, call them imploding, when those things implode and they get too much stress, you know, whether it's coming from the money or your veganness or your major ideal, let's say you're extremely religious, that when those things are not full embodied, they're not getting their kudos as they should, it becomes an implosion. Becomes an implosion on yourself. And so that big wheel where they were supposed to say, like, hey, you know, that's my party and I dance if I want to, that wheel just goes in and almost attacks you, you know, and you end up in an emotional state, as I am such tonight. You end up in an emotional state. That number was wrong, you know, that number is false, that number it's become an enemy to me, I've worked too hard for it to be so erroneous and hurtful. Okay, so there's the money number. there's the number of what they do to these animals, you know, the experimentals and all of these people, and they don't stop, you know. And I'm like, I support that everybody becomes vegan. I support that the world becomes a better place, and the people therein become smarter, and yet there is an implosion factor, because there is just horrible news on what has happened to those animals, what is happening, and now we've lost the blue parrot. It's gone into extinction. These types of things are, oh my gosh, how do you keep, you know, how do you go, you have your fortitude of ideal, and then it's just like a bombardment attack of that fortitude and ideal. And it just becomes an implosion. Sometimes, you know, the forces out there are too aggressive. The forces are out there are too aggressive, therefore you end up a smattering of emotions in the middle. Do you understand what I'm saying? Ay, ay, ay. Anyway, what else did I have here? There were other valuations of the self. It wasn't just about those ideals. It wasn't just about money. But those were the big, major ones. You know, those are the ones that really, that we make and break ourselves by all the time. You know, rather than, you know, she has such a good heart and she'll help you. You know, that's sometimes just like not even around. You know, there's the money association first about her, and there's her ideals, her strict, strong ideals. Okay, so now let's separate ourselves from those strict, strong ideals and those money numbers. Let's go, okay, wait a minute, I need a break from this, okay, me, myself, I need a break from them. Okay, they're getting attacked. Wapetas or whatever are always having some attack happen. The money system is having some attack happen. The economy maybe isn't doing what it's supposed to. So we have this attack, and that's the your economy is not doing so well. So you're like, wait a minute, I don't want to be compiled of these things. You know, can I put it back to that wheel? The wheel that is, you think of those old wagon wheels. Put it out there, and then give yourself some freedom in the middle. Freedom, and we're trying to reduce stress. You know, trying to reduce stress, or trying to not feel imploded by those events. We're supposed to just be in the middle, and while all of that is going on, trying to stress you out, trying to implode upon you, you have to breathe. You have to have a space in the middle that is not affected, that is just not affected by their, even though, let's say, like in the old westerns, it's funny, actually, my dad watches a lot of those, the old westerns, and they go out there and they used to fist fight all the time. You know, you see people and they fight, and they don't really do that so much anymore, but they used to. And it's that same thing, you know, that's where their ideals were, their fortitude of self, you know. You said something funny about my girlfriend, or you said something funny, and, you know, and that's where that person just lives, you know, every day, you know, that true grit part of them. Okay, but that true grit part of you really, really doesn't set you free. It doesn't give you a break. You're like, okay, let's say you work for Oceana or something. You don't get a break. You're only thinking about saving the whale, only saving the dolphins. You're not getting a break. You're not getting a, that is just become your person. You know what I mean? You know, everybody associates you with that person, with that type of what you do, your livelihood. They associate you that way. And you really have a tough time separating yourself from it. Okay, so the problem is that work or whatever you're doing here, like with the animals or the planet or blah, blah, blah. blah, you end up really stressed out, by that maintenance, you know, the maintaining that person, you know, that persona. That persona is, it's name tagged. It's your name tag. It's your numbers. It's the numbers that people have assigned to you, you know, your name tag numbers. And unfortunately, when you can't separate from that, you can't separate that. That just, what that does is that makes that wheel, really tiny, really close to you. And so you get really affected by it. Really affected by it all the time. And you lose a chance at finding who your real true self is. A freedom from it, a release from it. You know, it's like it's blocking your brain to only think those thoughts. Get out of those thoughts. Like this evening, you know, I'm in tears over, because I'm trying to get a credit card, and I'm in tears over the whole situation. But that's the implosion, you know, that's the implosion. It's just become too close to me, and I am just freaking out a little, you know, because that is something that I've always weighed super heavy as something that I am attainable at, I'm capable of, and it's never been a problem for me. And yet, I'm seeing a wall, and the wall is an attack. Do you understand? The wall is the attack. It's just like with the vegans and the paedas, when somebody hurts animals, that's the attack, you know. And when I know that I'm good with the money handling, and they are saying I'm not, that is an attack. Do you understand? And so that's hurtful, and so it's tough to not take it on board. It's tough to say, hey, I don't want it. I don't want that imploding on me, you know. It's tough because I've assigned myself the fact that I'm good with numbers, that I'm not going to have trouble, blah, 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 blah. And yet people are constantly throwing darts at me, constantly throwing, I mean, if they could get away with it, I believe they would start fire to something and throw them at me. I believe people are that hateful. Okay, just because I don't have good credit and I don't get a credit card, I can't get a credit card. I'm trying, but the point is, it's that assign, you know, I've assigned myself the fact that I'm good at it, and I can, and I'm capable. And when that falls through because of the others, it becomes a real disheartening, it becomes a real implosion. Okay, so we have this attack. So how do you free yourself from when the attack is happening? And they're all saying these little, I know this is fun, but yeah, online they say, we will send you a letter in 15 days. I'm like, my goodness, that doesn't sound good. If I'm going to get a letter in the mail in 15 days, it sounds like I've been shut out again. So, anyway, so here I am, you know, there's the 15-day letter attack. Okay, so what do you do? How do you deal with it? Tonight I lost it because it's too close to me. It's too much part of something that I hold too strongly. I hold too dearly. I hold too much that I am capable. That has become part of my person. That's really wrong. You know, it's really wrong that I've held such things that can be damned. Things that can be thieved and therefore later on be damned at. I should never assign that to myself. And nowadays they have a fun thing to alleviate everybody's pressure. Apparently $1 million, you can have yourself at $1 million in release money if you ever are in debt. One of these Experians or whatever say that. You get $1 million of fraud can happen, and they'll pay it. I mean, it's just absurd. And I'm just on the fire, the pyre fire. Now the pyre fire, though, I put myself, and I've allowed others to put me there. Okay, so the fire pyre, floating fire. I mean, with everything, it's for cognizance. You have to recognize what you are over-assigned yourself as. You know, what you've over-assigned yourself as. Now, I imagine it's tough because a lot of people, they have their job. You know, I'm a director, or I'm dancer. You know, they've assigned themselves this big job, you know. And it's very difficult for them to part from that. But when that job falls through, or the dancer falls through, you know, they get injured, or when the directorship falls through and they no longer have the work, they have an implosion. You know, that would be an implosion moment. You know. So we're dealing with letting that. Those moments when little pithy things happen to your director, your instructor, ballet instructor, or your, what's the other thing they do, dance, your dancer. When little pithy things happen from the outside, you know, try to hurt you. My gosh, remember there is a real you self in the middle before those things existed. And that was the one in the middle is the one, was the strong one that got you there in the first place, that made you that dancer, that made you that worker for Oceana. That was the one in the middle. The one in the middle is the most important. That is the strong. And it's not the education either. It's not the, hey, I got educated at this school and that's my association on the wheel. Sometimes people walk around with the school, you know, that's it. You know, they have that school. And that without that school, they're nothing. They can't see themselves any other way. And that is a wrong. They are better than that. They were something before that school. They were something before that tenure of workmanship or whatever they're doing. They were something else. That's the base person. You try to get back to the base human being. And the base human being is the one before the attack, but before the pithy, before the thieves, before the insults or the wave changes it. You know, we don't want them that short anymore. We want them really tall. I'm sorry, you're too thin. Yeah, we only want the bosoms, you know. We don't want them that way. You know, all of that. Imagine a model must be going like, I think I'm nuts, you know. A model must get that constantly. You know, they go into those jobs and they just have to redirect and redirect and redirect. I mean, eventually it's going to go to the heart, you know. It's going to be like, you know, take it to heart at some point. I mean, you can't be that callous and constantly be like, not this person, not that type of person, not this other type of person, and never fit in, and maybe one job out of 10 is yours, or one out of 100, you know. At some point, it is an effect, you know, very hurtful, a bunch of pithy. So we're trying to get back to that person in the middle, you know, before the wheels started coming in closer. Move that wagon wheel out and just look at it over there, you know. Okay, that's a credit bank account, or, you know, even if it is the best bank account in the world, you know, even if it's fabulous, try not to make that you. because that makes you kind of like a sicko, you know, walking in your bank account everywhere. If you separate yourself, stop valuing yourself with your strength, your fortitude, stop that. Bring yourself back to, it's an innocent time. It's an innocent time when you get back to your base person. You know, because it's a time before insults. And there's freedom there. There's freedom to breathe, freedom to not feel over emotional. It stops the attack. And then from there, push that covered wagon wheel out.